Alright. Okay. Apparently I need to license the right to stream things from Froman to be part of Stream World or whatever. Mr. BB Stream, Rainy D, is it Rainy D or Rained? The Rain Ed? I'm not sure. Why did I lose sound? Son of a bitch. It was playing and now it's not. Fuck. Last time I had to do this, I had to reboot the PS4. Oh, come on. Why you do this? Why you do this to me?
Why you do this?
Oh, thank you, Frisian Cold. I was worried that that gameplay wasn't super funny, but I guess we're kind of branching out into, like, more just traditional Let's Play games? Anyway, I wanted to turn that around as fast as I could. Damn it. No sound. Damn. Well, let's try. Yeah, we all fell in love with Mikolash, and then I murdered him, so sorry about that, everybody. I'll just unplug it and plug it back in. Surely that'll work. Got to the big white lady, which is not a racial thing. And then some dude invaded me and killed me. So that was cool. Still no sound. That's also cool. Shit. Okay, I know how to fix this. I've been through this before. Give me a second. So I gotta... Actually, I'll just straight up turn it off. You guys are gonna have a fun time of looking at me do nothing for a little bit. Actually, I would say I could put it in BRB mode, but I don't think, like, that will just replicate the problem I had where I switched it off of that and then lost sound completely. So we'll do this for now. Huh. Yeah, pretty good stream, huh? Thanks for the resub, D. Franklin. I wish I could help you. I wish I could prevent this from happening, but the PS4 is a little particular about when it decides to output sound, especially when it's pushing through an Elgato or a capture hardware. Hey, Limecat, Master. Emily, how's my day going besides my situation? Day's going pretty good. I, had a pretty sweet brunch breakfast situation. Awesome coffee. Please give me sound, please.
We didn't have to wait.
No. Yes! Okay, sound's there. Now, unplug you there, since the old PS4 has decided to output sound for once. And there! What time is it in Cali? It is 2:15. I did not go to PAX South, so Milt Jackson, I cannot answer your question. Joel and Matt went. Did you find the Disney Shorts YouTube channel I told you about on Twitter? Yeah, Enzo, you linked me to it. Which is great, because on the Disney channel, or on the Disney website, there's basically, it collects all Mickey Mouse cartoons in one big thing and doesn't even have like an episode list, so it's nearly impossible to just watch all the new ones. But yep, the no-death run continues. Probably end up beating the game without dying, so that's exciting. Lights seem a little dim, or maybe it's just bright outside, despite it actually raining for once. Randy, you're in the future? Have we been conquered by machines or aliens? Crank that up a smidge. Yeah. Crank that up. Yes. There we go. How's the no-death run going? Oh, it's going great. I'm still number one Bloodborne player in the world. Still haven't died. Still very, very good at the game. Speaking of which, I need to remember how to get back to where I was. I remember going up these elevators, so I'm going to do that. New Final Fantasy trailer looks like Metal Gear Solid. Parts of it did, yeah. Just like all the crazy machines, bullets and explosions. Ines Hodson, no worries. Replying to people on Twitter is fun. Gonna be in LA in September? Ooh. Man, that's a long way away. But I hope you enjoy your trip. After seeing you play the demo of the Division, are you exciting for the release? Tobias, I think I understand the game more, and I'm more willing to give it more time. I don't know that I'm thoroughly sold on it just yet. I'll play it. Yeah. Yeah, thank you, Maneater. Or Matonator. Matonator. Yes, they do not call me the Worldwide Bloodborne Champ for no reason. That is absolutely true. Well, I earned that title. Fuck. Okay, there we go. Do you follow the RPG site tweets? There will be a magic collecting system similar to 8. That's bizarre. I'm sure it's going to be reworked. The draw system was clever, but not really... In reality, it wasn't great. You just drew, like, every time you found a new spell, you drew 100 of it and then moved on with the game. Wasn't necessarily a very exciting way to spend one's time. Enzymatic, I did watch Yomushi Petal. The first episode was okay. I only saw the first episode. And I know this is going to sound dumb, because this is like a no-shit situation, but it was like super shonen. Like same formula, same template. And I know that that's what it is. Like, that's the name of the game, so it's silly to kind of say that it might not be worth it because of that. I guess I was hoping for something a little more charming or unique, but then again, there's plenty of time for that to develop. Yes, yes. Very angry. Fuck. Oh, shit. Oh, hey, my blood horns. I wasn't supposed to come this way. Oh, man. I need to turn the camera around. There we go. Hey, buddy. Well, this is already... Well, it killed something. They killed something. This is getting really serious already. Oh, delightful. Can you come down these stairs? Is that something you can do? These guys are worth a lot of echoes. Woo! Oh, you're mad. Ugh. God, those guys are worth 10k. That's ridiculous. And drop blood vials. Huh. Oh, hey. Fuck. Man. So this is possibly an endgame stream. I mean, probably. You've seen how good I am at it, so I'm probably gonna beat it without breaking a sweat. It seems like a really good place to farm echoes. I really want to run back to the lantern and just spend these. I have 100k, that's awesome. I'm gonna get these items. Blood vials, cool. More blood vials, cool. And this is where the creepy lady is, right? Up here? Yeah, there she is. Whoa! Probably gonna have to kill her or something. She sounds like she's having a great time. Man. Capped out on blood vials is great. Alright, yeah, I'm gonna go back to the Hunter stream. Spend my echoes. Gonna stream XCOM 2, probably. I really, really enjoyed the first one. I'm going to play the second one. It's coming out soon, right? There's a lot of good shit about to come out. Street Fighter 5? Beta's running right now. I'm gonna stream that too, but I haven't touched that game yet, and I kinda don't want to stream it before I get a chance to really grasp the at least the basics. Careful. Careful now. Careful. Oh. More blood vials. Good. Fuck. Ooh, damn, that hurt. Okay, fuck it. I'm not fucking with you. Why do you have to start the stream while working on my research paper? I have responsibilities. I'm testing your adulthood. Will you play with chat in Street Fighter V? I mean, if I get matched up against him, sure, but I'm probably not going to go out of my way to do that. I don't know. I've kind of explained this before, and I guess I might as well do that. Every time I explain it, I guess I make a little more sense of how I feel. I don't want... I want the way I interact with people in chat to be thoroughly egalitarian. I don't want the idea that, like, somebody's paying money or has been in chat longer. I don't want it to make it seem like that entitles somebody to, like, higher priority when it comes to, like, adjacency to me as a human being. And a way to boil that down is to say I don't want people to feel like they're paying to be my friend or paying to, like, spend time with me on the internet. I want that to be as, like, open and free as possible. And to me, whenever it's like, okay, if you're in chat, then I will play a game with you. Or if you're a sub, then I will play a game with you. I don't know. That starts, to me, starts to blur some lines. So I just keep it thoroughly to the throes of the internet. I don't want to be a spool streamer. I mean, Blinker, spool's not the idea. He didn't come up with the idea. A lot of streamers do that. I just don't... I guess I want to... This may sound a little cold, but I want to maintain healthy boundaries, if that makes sense. But, you know, at the same time, I heard the steak driver's pretty good. At the same time, I'll play games that have, like, open stuff or whatever, and whoever wants to join can. To be honest, I was also thinking about just doing a GTA, like, GTA Online catch-up day, streaming it personally, but, like, testing out all the maps I have backlogged. Because I'm kind of out, and I need to get some notes on some new stuff to try out. And, you know, fans have sent me maps, and I have them there, I just haven't played them. So it might be fun to spend, like, an evening just going through everything I have, seeing if anything's good. That looks like a cool weapon, but not skill. Strength. Ludwig's Holy Blade, but it's still nowhere near the DPS I can dish out with the Cane Whip. Taking into account Total Biscuit's recent reaction, I understand what you mean. I mean, yeah, I'm not looking for anything serious, that's kind of it. Hey, Grexter boy, welcome. It's something that I think could sound a little mean, but I think, yeah, Total Biscuit has had interactions with his fan base where he has to remind them, like, guys, we haven't met, like, we don't really know each other, and as familial as I am with you, or appear to be online, like, I don't know, I've definitely seen him have to remind people that, like, guys, like, we're not really friends, like, we haven't met in real life, and I know you and you know me, but let's remind ourselves of the nature of that interaction. Oh, yeah. So, yeah. Hope that doesn't sound too cold or distant, but that's kind of what's going through my head. Gonna buy VR sometime this year. Yeah, I already pre-ordered it, so as soon as it's ready to ship, I think in May is what they said. I get to get billed, and they're going to ship me a sweet headset. So your Lime Cat asks, so considering internet controversies are always fun to talk about, what do you think about the whole Fine Brothers thing? I think that they are making a calculated grab and trying to do something kind of daring, and if it works out, they will be fucking rich, but I don't think it's going to work. I don't think they're going to be able to get away with it. But, that said, I'm no attorney, and... I think that most of this stuff hasn't been figured out, and I think it's kind of mean. It's kind of like when Nintendo said that they were going to start claiming videos. Everybody was like, fuck you, but they were the first to do it, and the world didn't stop turning. It's just they kind of changed the rules a little bit. And people have to adapt. That's, you know what, when you build your castle on YouTube, you gotta, part of that is knowing that the platform will change while you're on it. And that's scary, and if you don't like that, then don't be a media producer on an ever-shifting platform.
Farewell, good. May you find.
So, I don't know. I tend to get very amoral. Not immoral, but amoral when it comes to issues like this. Like, this is business. It's business, it's law. And it's creative content, and you, honestly, like, the world doesn't need free access to reaction videos. I really don't think that those contribute meaningfully to the culture of the world. I mean, they do, in a way. I think that they're like a, I think they spread culture, which is kind of cool. I think it's a good export of culture, but I think that the world is not aching for another, like, Citizen Kane of reaction videos. So, Well, on principle, it seems a little weird to want to lock down a like a concept for a video, or even just the word react by itself. I guess where my mind goes is if they didn't do it, somebody else would, and they tried to do it before somebody else did. And if it doesn't work, fine, but at least they took the shot, and that's how business goes. If you're a first mover, and you set the precedent, then you're set. You're set for life. So, I don't know. It's just people testing what they can get away with. And if they can't get away with that, then everyone else will not try it. Because it's been tested. What's up? Oh, man. What's up, Cosmo Ass Man Kramer? God, that's a hell of a name. What's up, Katie? What's up, Brittany? Uh-oh. Wait, is this Hook again? You're not gonna trick me. It is. You tricked me. How do you feel that you are now a boss in this game? Oh, you mean that I'm good at it? Oh, I feel good. I mean, I'm good at every video game, so I'm used to it. Did you really eat 20 chicken McNuggets and 2 apple pies while watching Tango and Cash? Not Tango and Nash, but yeah. Yeah, I felt disgusting. I don't think I've ever felt that gross than I did then. That's just like the most gluttonous I've ever been. I think I dunked them in honey, too, so it was just like fried meat covered in sugar. Blech. Skip all the other stuff you murgled off Middle Bonfire. Okay. Yeah, I'll check that out. I just knew that this was a pretty direct path, so... And the elevators are pretty long, but they're not so bad. Oh! Wow. Somebody asked if I'm gonna be playing the DLC. I don't know, is the answer. It depends how frustrated I am by the time I finish. I got a lot of other games I want to play. I've been going through The Witness, and that is a lot of fun. I really enjoy that. Oh, boy. And then, like I said, Street Fighter V's out now. Oh! Oh! A lot of ass. Woo! We juking and jiving. Alright, you guys fight. I'll deal with the detritus. Alright, who's gonna make it up? God damn, that's an easy way to farm vials. Woo! Vials and echoes. Oh, there's another one? Nope, just that one, okay. Look, 37k just for sprinting here and killing a couple dudes. Man, I'm gonna spend some time here if the end of the game is too annoying. Wait. Katie's your sub? Did I miss that? What's up, Jimmy? Hold on, I gotta readjust my monitor a little bit. So hold on a minute now. Oh shit! Well, fuck. Fuck me. It happened. It really happened. Alright, guys. That's a special day. It's a very special day. Because Ms. Katie Bacon has been waiting a year, an entire year for this. Man, I feel like I should be wearing a suit or something. Maybe a tie. Alright, Katie. Thank you for subbing an entire year. We put a lot of money into this jukebox. So I hope it was worth it. Please enjoy your song. And everybody else should enjoy it too. Actually, shit, no. Fuck it, we'll play it from the beginning. Oh, it's beautiful. What a magical day. What a wonderful day. What's up, Streznak? The song is like 30 years old. Oof. That's accurate. That is an accurate thing. Jade, you don't thank me. You earned it. Alright, let's go get tore up by this laughing lady. If there's one thing I've learned, it's when a woman is laughing by herself, you should probably go up and talk to her. How you doing? How you doing? Oh. Hey there. Can you not talk to her? You just have to murder her? That doesn't seem right. She's just chilling. This boss is pretty sweet lore-wise. Oh, man. One of these days, I have this weird fantasy in my head that I'll be able to play one of these games. I'll be able to play one of these games and just really get into it. And get into all the lore. But contextually, just like read all the item descriptions and kind of put it together myself. I don't think that's going to happen. Huh. Restores this larger amount of HP. I only get one, though? Strange. Oh, shit. And Skrilla just subbed. Alright. I know people... I've heard some people get a little annoyed when people sub and it stops the stream, but... I don't know. To me, it's like... It doesn't stop the stream. Who cares about me playing some random-ass video game? I guess some people do. It's hard for me to put myself in that mindset. Okay. There was a good album that came... Okay, here we go. Yeah. This album came out recently. So I'm gonna play. It's pretty hot track. Pretty hot, newly dropped track. So I know you guys are gonna like it. Because honestly, who doesn't like this kind of music? Alright. And Skrilla, thank you for subbing. Here's your weird song. I hope you like it. Electro banjo rock. That is actually a pretty good descriptor. Person from one of my gigs knew who you were. You were at a drag queen club. Shit, yes. Man, I'm getting in tight with the right circles. I saw a picture today of a drag queen dressed as Shiva from Mortal Kombat, and it was the most fierce thing in the world. Oh, hello. Where does this go? Oh, is this the mid bonfire you guys were talking about? Electro Bluegrass? Is that an actual title of a thing? Because that is an amazing combination of words. Oh! 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 Okay, I can skip all that shit. That's nice. Alright. I thought that thing only went down. Alright. What song was that? Fuck, it's reloading the tab. Chrome's getting really good about saving memory, by the way. If anyone else noticed. So the song is called Protectors of the Realm. And it's from a band called, Kaminanda. Kaminanda. They used to do what's called dub, which is like a weird kind of reggae trip hop down tempo electronica. It's really good to work to, because it's got a good beat and it's kind of relaxed but still really interesting and complicated. So I've been listening to a lot of that stuff at work lately, and that's kind of one of the bands I tuned into that I really liked. So, if you like weird-ass, kind of world-esque electronica, remember Cooperator. Beware of Fall. God damn it. How long am I planning on streaming? I don't know. What's up, Dan the Predator? No, worry. Dude, don't worry about... You're at the boss once you go up the next elevator. That's what I figured. Yeah, dude, don't worry about doing life stuff. That life is for doing life stuff. Do not sacrifice life things for internet things. It's not that important. Aw, oh, man. This cage head fella. Don't kill the king, kill the nurse. Got it. Ooh, Cypher 406 just subbed! We're gonna make our way to this boss eventually. Alright, another sub hype. No problem. No problem. I can take all comers. So this just dropped today. I was listening to it in the car. I liked it. So I'm gonna play it now. Aw. New shit. Hot new tracks. With DJ Me. So thank you, Cypher. Cypher 406 for subbing. Please enjoy your song. Can't give it all away. It's not mine. But man, good shit. So that's from the new Saint Lucia. There is no song command. Sorry, man. I don't have a bot set up or anything. This is just me playing shit in the back. But yeah, it's from Saint Lucia. The album's called Matter. Track is Help Me Run Away, as you may have guessed. But yes, it does sound like you are in an aerobics class in 86, which is awesome. I do feel determined. Jesus. So this is it, right? Like, this is the last boss? I have the most Catholic taste. I don't think you're using that word right. You know the band Ghost BC? I know Ghost Beach. Is that who you're talking about? Because I love them. But yes, I'm DJ Yowie Hands, aka DJ Awesome, aka DJ Terror Alert Yellow, aka DJ Me, aka DJ Lar. Oh shit. Damn it. Fuck is. Shit is fucked. Second to last. Alright. Yeah. Man, there's just a crying baby in the middle of... DJ Rootkit, also. Wanna see me trying to speedrun something with 80, motivational 80s songs in the background? Like a montage? Ghost BC. Okay, here, let me open this tab. Wait, just Ghost? I know Ghost. Why do you keep saying BC? Oh, no, wait, no, I'm... Oh! That's cool! Oh, that's a really cool monster design! Hey! Ho! Alright, you got swords. You got a lot of them. Oh, God, it's playing, like... Hey! Ha! It's playing crib music. Hey! Ha! Okay, is this an in-and-out boss? Surely it's gonna, like, flip the fuck out. When it gets hurt, right? Oh! Oh! God. It just slashes all around. Okay, it's got a huge hitbox, though. That's good. It is kind of interesting how Souls games have come to, like, understand and even bank on player behavior. Like, circle straight for... Oh, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh shit. Okay, so this is your get fucked mode. Okay. It doesn't seem to be able to see me, which is weird. Ooh. Okay. Oh, okay, it's faster. That's my in. Alright guys, I'm gonna play this one real safe. Oh shit, it doesn't do that much damage, surprisingly. Surely it's got like a rage mode, it's got to. Come on, you. Give me an animation I can predict. That's being really kind to me. Is it weird that I think that? That like this is a little... spookily easy so far? Or is it just that I can outrange it and I'm lucky that way? It walks in a straight line. She walks in a straight line. I'm assuming a wet nurse is male. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. What does that mean? Wait, oh. That was it? Too close. Oh! Oh! That one hurt! Okay, don't do that. Don't do that. That was too risky. Okay, last time you did this, it wasn't a big deal. Oh, that's a big deal. Oh, there's two! Shit. Okay. There's an illusionary one? Alright, alright. Fuck! Shit. Okay, it got a lot harder. Fuck. Oh! Okay, alright, I get it now. What are you doing? Ah! Oh! Oh, no! Okay, okay. Okay! So, probably just dodge a lot. Only take attacks of opportunity during that phase. Alright. Come on, do an attack. Oh! Okay. Damn it. Fuck. Just out of range. Come on, you. Ooh, I got lucky. Shit. Ooh, lucky. One more? Alright. Oh, fuck. Damn it. Where are you? Don't cast the thing. I'm trying to do damage while it's not in clone mode. Just to make sure I kill it before it does that again, because that was really scary. It's doing this thing. Fuck. Ah, shit, it tagged me. Alright, get up. Oh, no! Oh! That was the easy part. There's no prey slaughtered. Oh! Oh, why did it take so long? You almost had to fight three? Oh, so he casted a... Oh, shit. Woo, that's scary. Man, I would have just been hammering circle. Oh, okay. Alright, we did it. We borned. Oosh! Deathless run continues. I guess you go to the Hunter's Dream. I got an umbilical cord. That's cool. Stephanie got California rolled at the salon. Oh yeah, just so you guys are aware, Stephanie's getting some new internet terminology off the ground. You're gonna wanna... You have three one-third chords. Crush them to get the true ending. So just so you guys know, just so you're on board here. There's a new term going around. You guys need to know about it. Stephanie's getting it, kind of taking it off here. It's called getting California rolled. It's when you're in a public place and you hear Hotel California. Ah, we got California rolled. So there you go. One third. I only have one of them. So I guess they're all optional bosses. There was a sub hype. What? For purely illogical. Ha! Sub hype. Cool, man. Thank you for subbing. Whoops. I gotta mute the game before I do that. Well, thank you for subbing. Hold on, let me dig back into my tracks, find something good. Yeah, you know what? We'll do a new fucking new music stream. So purely illogical. Thank you for subbing. Please enjoy your song. That is the new block party. Apparently Brittany's a fan. Alright. I guess I can level up more. I don't really know anything else to do. What's this dab? Is it this dance craze all the kids are doing? Hey, shit! Shit's on fire! Fuck! I didn't even notice! Everything still works, though. Whatever, man. Sure. How do you like your eggs? This is important. I typically go over hard, but I dabble. I don't really have a standard. I'll try different things from different places. I think there's more variance in scrambled. I think you can go to a restaurant and try their scrambled eggs. Like, do you put milk in it? Do you put cream in it? Do you put pepper in it? Like, I don't know. You can kind of get a feel for the chef in that area. But I think eggs are. I enjoy them all sorts of ways. What the fuck? I wasn't paying attention. Chalice ritual. Connect chalice ritual to create a chalice dungeon. Find an accessible chalice dungeon. Find a chalice dungeon. Use a chalice glyph. What does that mean? Are the dungeons not pre-made? So if you get a... Talk to the old guy. So if you get a, if you get a chalice, that just doesn't unlock a pre-made dungeon? Has Rancid ever been a sub-hype? No. But just so you're aware, the rules are, if you ask for it, I can't play it. I have to surprise you guys. This isn't fucking request hour. Such a long answer for such a simple question. Yeah, I do that. I forgot where the old guy is. He's like chilling in the garden, right? Oh, did I see him just then? Nope, I saw a tombstone. Damn it. Sometimes he's sitting in there. How to be an adult? Buy a coffee pot. I don't know. I feel like the first time you pay your taxes. That's not true, though, because I did that when I was, like, 15. What did I think of the division? What? It's interesting. Talk to the doll to find the old man. All right. It's got some interesting ideas. I don't know how there'll be an execution.
Good hunter, dawn will soon break. This night and this dream will end. Gammon awaits you at the foot of the great tree.
Let's do it! Might as well, level up while I'm here. Damn, it's a lot more health. And since I don't really care about echoes anymore, I may as well swap out my runes for something survival-ish. Because if I, this is the last boss. Doesn't really matter at this point. So, I don't really care about visceral attack. I'm probably not going to be visceral attacking the boss much. Stamina's good. So visceral attack, physical damage reduction. Got all types of resistance plus. That's awesome! Sure. Who knows what the last boss is going to be? I'll fucking go for it. Might as well get max HP 5. Yep, there we go. Interesting. So if you add resistance, suddenly it has to, like, tick up to that. How bizarre. Foot of the Great Tree. Alright. Chalice dungeons are partially procedurally generated. Interesting. I did not know that. Also don't know where the Great Tree is. Is there a big-ass tree around here somewhere? Depending on what choice you choose, there is no last boss. Alright. Well, I want a last boss. I like bosses. That's the reason I play these games. Well, it's environment design and bosses. Because, goddamn, the boss looks so metal as shit. Go down to the graveyard. Alright. Like most of my sessions playing Bloodborne, it's filled with me wandering around in circles and wondering what I'm supposed to do. Get the last boss, refuse to submit. Okay. So I'm curious. Like, what if I fight the last boss and it's a total pain in the ass and I just want to give up? Hug the outer fence and you'll find it. Alright. Oh, is it down here? Yeah, here we go. So you know if you want next boss. Alright. Man, that's pretty. Jeez. Like you're in the middle of your Solid 3. Oh, there he is. Thank you for the resub, Space Kitty. Oh, is the bad ending if you refuse? Wait, did you get the 3 items? Do not talk to the boss until you do. No, I didn't. I'm not going to. I just want to beat the game. It's a pain in the ass. It's the last boss. That's a good point. Good point, Andrizzles. So, do I not get to fight the last boss? If I don't have all the umbilicals? I only got one of them. I don't think I used any of the other ones. Brooches. Use it to gain a blood gem. Oh, okay. Wait, where is it? Thought it was in here. Wait, there it is. Yeah, so I only have one. Rich Devote, yeah, of course. 3 items are super easy to get, and do not get to fight the true boss until you do. With all cords, you get a second last boss and the true ending. I don't care about true endings, that's the thing. I don't care about the plot of Bloodborne. Just talk to him and say no, you'll fight a boss. Sounds good to me. I can watch the true ending on YouTube. I don't feel like doing that homework.
Good hunter.
Plus, part of me feels like if this is the experience I was going to have without a guide or without the internet, then it's what I should have. Now, not the true ending, whatever. Mercy.
You will die. Forget the dream.
The second boss is the real boss and is a real test. You will damn it, now I kind of want to... Well, it's too late, right? Can I just walk away from him? Alright, fuck it. Let's get these dumbass umbilicals. You guys talk me into it. If this second boss is worth it, because I like playing the bosses, it better be worth it. There we go. Location. Oh, so there's theoretically four. Can be found in the old abandoned workshop. Killing the baby Ariana gives birth to Tomb of the Odin. Oh, Jesus Christ. Dropped by Yovska in her clinic on the first floor sick room through the entrance of Woodman Woods. Once Rom, the spider has been defeated. So I need to kill her prior to the boss fight. Okay. Wait, so there are two missable ones, so it's possible you don't even get all three. The second boss has the coolest design, in my opinion. Yeah. Go collect the items. There should be four. Kill them to get them, or give it in time, go find them later, etc. Okay. So it says the second one is in the old abandoned old workshop. Hunter's Dream is a replica of this place. Entering the area will unlock trophy. Finding the piece gives you two insight. Where is it? After defeating the Bloodstarved Beast, go to the Cathedral Warden under the door on the white. Oh my god! Here we go. Alright. We're doing this. At least I killed Bloodstarved Beast already. Maybe I'll run into other optional bosses and just fucking lay waste to them. Because I'm all leveled up. With my sweet cane whip. Alright. Cathedral Ward. Yeah. Workshop is easy to go to. It's called Ambience. Ugh. Yeah, Tums has a really important question. Which ending has the hottest boss? Which boss is a middle-aged attractive man? Perhaps a dad type, if you will? Perhaps a slight beard? A small gut, maybe? Looks like he could change a tire. To defeat the Lesser Beast, kick through the ward, enter the door on the right, take the elevator up, cross the room with the wheelchair enemy, and don't enter the next building, go around the building to the right side, drop down, and enter the doorway further ahead. Alright, go to the right, take the elevator up. How did you get involved with Machinima and subsequently Funhouse? Milt Jackson, I got a job freelance writing for Machinima in 2010? Because of somebody, or rather, through somebody I used to work for on a free volunteer blog website. Oh yeah. This place! This is the gun place! This is what I was trying to find forever ago. Oh, whatever. So, basically, I worked with a certain individual on a free website a long time ago. We kind of had a working... we had met each other before, had worked together before, so we knew how we worked, even if we weren't getting paid for it. And then he got a job at Machinima, and then was hiring up for things related to Inside Gaming. And they had a blog at the time, and they were trying to get on Metacritic. So they were farming out a ton of written reviews to build up a bank of work that they could leverage to get on Metacritic. So they were looking for freelancers to write reviews, and I was one of them that they, because I'd written reviews for this guy before, he's like, yeah, we'll send him some work. So I started working remotely. And by things that appear to me, I was just I was easy enough to work with and kind of had a good work ethic and always turned my stuff on time and it was of generally high quality. So I just kept getting more work and when more opportunities came up, I was considered to do them and then I got a job offer. Then I moved out to LA, so that's kind of where it went. Okay, so here we go. Where is it? Sorry, I got distracted. Cross the room with the wheelchair enemy, don't enter the next building, go around the right side, drop down, enter the doorway further ahead. Don't enter the building, go around the right side, door further ahead. Yeah, back when I was trying to farm up bullets. Ow! I remember. Around here. Drop down. Ha! Door further ahead. What hurt me just then? Alright. There are several drops here, and the goal is not to reach the bottom. Drop on the left side before the walkway to land on a small platform. Left side before the walk. Wait. Well, I remember this. I remember going down and. I think I have to get there. No. Wait, where am I? Let's see here. It says. Drop on the left side before the walkway and land on a small platform. Drop again on the next platform and open the door, and then you'll be in the workshop. Okay, so there's a door halfway down. I have to check. To seduce by backseat cameras or section option areas and more bosses you can visit. No, I am not sweating optional bosses unless I run into them. Unless they look particularly cool. Because someone in chat can vouch that there's a really wicked boss that is cool and awesome. Even then, it has to be worth the time. I'm done with this because it's like, it's the end of the game, and if anything should be special, it should be this. Alright, where's that door? I want to make sure I see it before I start dropping. Out of my way, barrels. I've got a door to find! Is that it? I don't think that's it. But yes, if there are any dad bosses, I'm down with that. Wrong drop. Already? Are you kidding? I have to go over there? I didn't see how to land on that. Oh, now I see how to land on it. Shit. So it's there. Wait, there's a... Wait, what? Oh, that! Right? That thing? Yeah, it's probably that. Fuck. Well, I guess I can go back to the Hunter's Dream. 27,000? Fuck it. Oh, I got plenty of these. I already missed it. Yeah. Do you think university is a waste of time and money? Irem, I don't know about waste. I think it's all about what you make of it. But I think by default, it's probably not worth the time and money. And that's mostly because it's getting really, really expensive. I think it's worth a good deal. But I think paying for it all out of pocket is prohibitively expensive. Unless your parents have saved up a lot of money, or perhaps you have an exceptionally high-paying job. So, I would say do consider other alternatives. I think if you're especially concerned about money or maybe don't think you have the means, a student loan is not the only option you have. There's always military service and community college. I think what's viable, especially for people that are looking to get into digital entertainment, is to go to community college, work a part-time job. You can pretty if you have it, if you have anything other than minimum wage, and you're not terrible with your money, you can probably make a go. Oh, it's to the left for some reason. It really doesn't look like there's anything to land on down there. Oh, that's really far. So, yeah, I would say what I would probably do, my strategy would probably... I think I can land on that and not die. Let's give it a shot. Nope, I'm dead. Bounced all the way down. Wham! There we go. I would go to community college, I would work a part-time job, and then in my off time, I would work on this kind of media. Because you do have time to take classes, work a job, and play video games. And then stream and, like, pick up a thing. So that way you can both build digital production experience, even though you're doing it on your own, and then also like get a more formal, more recognized education. And then at the end of those 2 years, once you have your associates, maybe three if you find the workload too hard, not only will you theoretically have been supporting yourself, so you're just kind of like better at life, better at things like, you know, cooking for yourself, doing laundry, showing up to work on time. Like, managing responsibilities, really. You get some practice at that. You get some practice at school, which is a skill you can get better at. Just learning how to do school work. And then you also build experience editing, publishing videos. And there's no guarantee it's going to lead to anything, but it's a step in the right direction. So I have to fall down on this side, huh? Huh. Meh. That's the only thing there's anything to land on. That's what I'm trying to do right now. Some great reassurance. Emily, I'm not telling you it's going to work. That's just what I would do. Drop off at the left of the note. Here? Doesn't seem like I'm going to land on anything. It really doesn't seem I'm going to land. Look for the ropes and roll at them. Like that? Ugh. Theater major with a minor in gender studies. Okay, well. Then you will have to find... You're probably not going to find working, like, work in your field. If I was going to plans for the 1-year anniversary, no. Oh, that one! Ah, clever. And I don't know if anyone told you that that was something that was going to be easy to get, but if they did, you may have been misinformed. You can probably find something that pays, especially if you work your ass off, but it's not going to be, like... I think getting by is probably the best you can hope for. Interesting. So there was another workshop. And this one's all Blood Mooned. Old Hunter Bone hype. What's up, Kala? Big dicks already? It's been a weird ass day, so stream is nice. ONFS man, I hope it gets better. You guys ever need to call HR for anything? I mean, just normal stuff. If we have questions about health insurance or junk like that. If you're worried about, like, workplace discomfort or harassment, no, definitely not. Go into the church and the item is on the thing. You will see it. Alright. This is the workshop. The one you visit is a dream version. Interesting. That's why it's called the dream. Cool. Alright. So the other two are missable. And I'm not going to be... Well, I guess I'll just be... Oh, Hunter Bone! That's probably where I'm just going to be back to square one if I can't get all of them, so whatever. We got to spend this extra quality time together. Where's that? Oh, it's a spell. Okay. I think Lurewise is the original. You didn't miss out on the next one, you're fine. Okay. Well, there's two next ones, theoretically. Let's see what we got here. Okay, after killing Mergo's wet nurse, got that. Confounded, the abandoned old worship did that. Killing the baby Ariana gives birth to a tomb of Odin's sewers, or killing her at Ayefska Clinic if you brought her there after killing Mikolash, host of the nightmare. Tomb of Odin. Okay, sewers. Tomb of Odin sewers. I don't know if I've been there yet. And I know that the other one was at the university or whatever. Tons of volunteer programs for young adults. You don't want to go into college. AmeriCorps? Yeah, that works too. I don't know, I think a lot of... There is a chest where the messenger shop is used. Uh-oh. Well, I just lit a thing, so... Graveyard of the Dark Beast. That sounds awesome. Okay. Where was I headed? Sewers or something? Tomb of Odin. I don't know if I've been there. Alright, Deep Franklin. See you later. Oh! The one good chance you missed. Go for the other. Do the clinic. IMO is the most easy out of all of them. Clinic. I don't see a clinic thing. Oh, I see. First floor sick room through the entrance to the... Through the entrance to the Forbidden Ones once Rom has been defeated, as long as you didn't kill her prior to the boss fight. I don't think I've been there at all, so yeah, that one's probably still there. Do you think I missed this one? I don't remember killing this person. I also don't remember where the sewers are. Wait, yeah, I should probably go to the other one. That seems a lot more direct anyway. What is it here? First floor sick room through the entrance from the Forbidden Woods. Okay. What's up, Cauliflower? I mean, sorry. I already said hello to you. Anything interesting happened in chat so far? Talked a lot about eggs. So that was interesting. That was fun. When I did that. That was Australia. It was awesome. It was very, very cool. I feel very, very hashtag blessed to have been a part of that. A lot of excitement, a lot of happy people. Oh, RJDO1995 just subscribed. Well, all right. Let me find a good track then. Yeah, this is good. I like this one. Ah, don't kill me. I mean, he couldn't if he tried because of, you know, all the skill, but. Because of all the mad skill. Okay, RJ Dio, thank you for subbing. Let's play a nice chill track for you. really need to get a crossfader. Because, God, it's just, it's a fuck up of the cut to shut it off like that. Noir porn. Nice. Yeah. Yeah, it's basically like the silhouetted sex scene in every 80s movie. Where there's, like, curtains blowing in the wind and some girl's, like, doing this thing. Run to the area with a big hole in the ground over the small gate. Go past it, then look for a cage with a lot of dogs. Run past those and go into the cave. When the cave, run around, avoiding the crap in it. Run the exit, then climb the ladder. And get to the top. Open the gate to be safe. Okay. Oh, they're not one hit! Bullshit! God damn it. Ugh. I'm like 2 HP away from killing them in one shot. Ah. Alright, well. Alright, let's go find this big hole. Ah. Damn it! Pretty much keep left. I like those instructions a lot better. You guys soul punks. Yeah, I was Torchman. I don't think this is the left you were talking about, though. I'll keep left aside from that. What song was that? Learning to Beat Life. That was a song called Croms, C-R-O-M-S, from a band called... Wait, no, I think I have that backwards. Yeah, the band is Croms, I think. Yes. Croms is the band. The name of the song is Invisible Cities. That's right from where you are, then go right. Alright. Could be a Garden Story T RTX? Awesome. Thank you for that. I am... Jesus, dude! I'm always amazed how giving people are with their time, the Guardians. My favorite weed legalization, lol. I kinda am, I... It doesn't seem like a thing that hurts anybody. And there's no reason that, like... God damn it. These guys are taking a lot of chumps off of me because I'm not paying attention. I think if you compare it to something like alcohol or even tobacco in terms of the damage it does societally, it's silly that those are allowed and weed is not, so. But you know what? Society doesn't always make sense. You just kind of live in the society you're in and abide by the rules. Don't have to agree with all of them, but that's the system. That's alright. It's pretty okay. To admit I'm obsessed with an actor. Which actor, Kala? Ah! Okay. I don't think that was right. Just shit. Well, there's the hole. Guys, I found the hole. You're fine. Alright. Just clip through that board right there. Good call. Good moves. Well, there's an item here, so might as well take that. What? Who's mad at me now? You're a vicious hell monster. Did an emote, damn it. Any of the Funhouse team have a comic collection? I don't think so. James has read a lot, or rather he's studied a lot, which is weird to say. He's caught up on a lot of the, like, canon of it, but I think that may come from, like, reading Wikipedia articles. That's not me calling him out, by the way. It's more the way he describes it. He says that, like, such and such a storyline is really cool to read in summary, but not in comic book form. Which is maybe... believe he's read some summaries. That's the gate behind you. You guys, okay, you can't use relative instructions because I'm moving a lot, so by the time you give it to me, I'll be in a different space. I'm not complaining, I'm just trying to tell you guys that when you say, like, it's to the left or to the right, or it's behind you, be aware that I see that, like, there's a lag involved, so. A taco literacy course? What? God bless college. Well, you'll give us money just for doing a class on nothing? Like, a lot of it? Shit, yeah! We'll teach you about anime and tacos. Go back to where you looted items in the first house. Stop out and go left. Step out and go left. Okay. Oh, I think I know what you're talking about now. Okay. Think Rooster Teeth Funhouse could use someone with a police background. It's an interesting question. Doesn't occur to me how that would be a thing. Or that skill set. But for all I know, it might be good. I saw that trap up there. Okay, so should I just keep going left? How's it working out? Coming along not well, Julian. I have a hernia, so I haven't been able to work out as intensely as I would like to. And I think this has led to an amount of weight gain, especially since it was over the holidays and shit. Good news is that I am going to have that operated on this week, and a month from then it should be all healed up, 100%. So I can go back to working out. And I was on I hit a pretty good pace. Something died. I hit a pretty good pace before the condition occurred, or rather that I had identified that it was there. I was doing insanity 4 times a week, and it was starting to have a pretty quick effect. But no, that had to stop because there's a lot of intense core work in that, obviously. So been slow since then. But a month from now, should be back on my game. I'm very excited for that. Oh boy, not that way. All right. Yeah, I could be a security guard. If you're fat, you just love food, and who the fuck doesn't? That's true. You can love... shit. You can love food and still... It was right after the gate, not left. Okay. You can love food and still not be overweight. I don't want to use the term healthy, but just, you know... I think it's, like, objectively good to have low body fat. I think that's pretty proven, regardless of all the feelings around it. And it's possible to love food, but just eat the right kinds of food or be very rigorous with portion control. So you can still have food that tastes good and that you like, but... And then if you feel like eating a lot, you do, but you also counter that with periods of not eating or of more restraint or of more exercise. You talked about it yet, but what do you think about all this internet drama regarding the Fine Brothers stuff? Various bits of the internet freaking out. I did talk about it a little. Oh, hey, there's a... I'm gonna listen to this person real quick. This is real spooky. A most frightful fate. Oh my. But I'm willing to do you a kindness. Oh. Step lightly round to the right of the great cathedral and speak. Left from him, okay. Shrouded church. The gift of the Godhead will grant you. Canehurst? Canehurst a person or is it a place? Canehurst is a place. If there's a hot dad I need to deal with, I will. Okay. Whoops. So I kind of said this before. So I apologize if I'm reiterating myself. I'll summarize it a little more, I guess, this time. I don't know. My take on all that stuff is what they're doing is not illegal, and they're testing the boundaries. What's up, drunken bar fight? There's nothing wrong with testing boundaries. That's what people do. That's how all business is done. If you accept precedent, then somebody else is going to try it, and if they get it, then they get all the money, and they get set. They establish the empire or whatever. So, left there, right at the cages. So I don't think people treat it like a moral issue, and I just don't really see it that way. I mean, I agree that, like, I think on an emotional and personal level, I think it's kind of silly to try and react some or try and trademark something so broad, and that it's also a little like, come on, guy, like, you're gonna do that. But I've never worked with them, so I don't know anything about them. I also just don't watch many reaction videos. That's just me, whatever. But they're popular, people like them. But I would, where I come back to, just in terms of like a business sense and the way the world works sense, they didn't do it, someone else would. Because somebody's going to try. Oh shit! I heard that coming up, I jumped. I didn't even see him until they were on me. Oh my god, that was scary. So yeah, the whole idea of a free market is that people try things and try to find new businesses and new ways of making money. That's American as shit. And you know what? I'm not gonna fault him for trying, and I'm gonna watch and hope that the system works and that this doesn't pan out. But you know what? They tried it. They tried it, and that's what makes this whole system work. It's people trying new things and trying to find ways to earn money. So I don't see it as much of a moral issue, even though I think it's a little dumb myself. But then again, it's not my work. And you know what? If I had the shot to, like, I don't know, license Let's Play or whatever, like if I tried to be Sony. Let's see here. Left of the dog cages. Ugh. Okay, so I missed it again? I mean, you can't fault them for trying, right? Who wouldn't do that? As much as commenters on the internet like to be like, oh, this is just morally reprehensible. I'm like, yeah, big deal. If you had the shot to be set for life, you would take it. Especially how something as seemingly inconsequential as trademarking people watching other videos. The losing subs, yeah, I know. I mean, don't get me wrong, I understand the reaction to it. And I'm not trying to defend it. I want to make that very clear. But it's just like, this is the way the system works. This is just it. You're watching it happen. And I mean, the other part of that is, the system can also work, so if you do something really seemingly, go left at the dog cages, like run behind them but left, okay. If you do something seemingly, grabby, and you like present a bad face to the public, they might react to that. So oh, I see now. Jeez. I just see me spin in circles. Martyr Logarius is the dad boss. Okay, let me check this out here. Yeah, you don't have to accept it. That's absolutely right. So I think you're just seeing, like, you're just seeing the free market at play. He's not, I mean, I guess he's got a beard. He's all dead. I don't know about that. He looks cool. So there's that. It's different when your business is so dependent on people liking you and your direct content and personality, I think. You can't technically fault them for trying. Their subs and people who would have been on their who would have been their customers can. Yes, you're right. I also have faith that people are going to forget about this. The world will turn again. People will watch reaction videos. And the Fine Brothers will not take that big of a hit on this. I think they'll be fine. Even if they have to rebrand or change their name or something. I even think that would be a little short-sighted. I think given time and distractions, people let a lot of stuff slide. I don't mind react videos, but when they just sit silently and then go, I hope you like this video, like and sub, you get a little annoyed. I can see that. That sounds annoying. Especially if you're just watching somebody watch something and they're like, well, I made this content for you. Don't call this content. I mean, if it's produced, again, I feel like I should really make this really clear. The Fine Brothers are producers, and they produce those videos, and they're good at it. They know exactly what they want, and they know how to get it. And to me, that's the hallmark of a great producer. A talented producer. Oh, shit, you're a big fucker. But if it's somebody just turning on their webcam and recording for 5 minutes and being like, hey, if you want more content, it's not content. That's not content. That's you watching a webcam. Like, this isn't content. No way would I ever use that word. This is time killer. For you guys, I mean. For me, it's fun. Oy. Okay, so I gotta... Luckily, this guy's pretty docile. He's just chilling. Can you guess how many hours of video you've cut? Just go right until you see the cave out. Is it that? Oh! Fuck you! Snake man! Oh! It got complicated! Oh, oh, shit! Hopefully I'm over-leveled for this place. Fuck, it's snaking! God damn it! God! Stop it! Where all these damn snakes come from? Fuck you! Ugh. I got complicated. I got real complicated. Okay. Okay, so is that where I came in? Oi. Or do I just keep following this wall? I think I do. Snakes are kicking my ass. Yeah, they were. Those snakes suck. Not a whole lot around this way. Now I'm gonna get poisoned. Oh, shit! Snakes! It's impossible to see them! God damn it. Alright, well, no death run continues. Shit. Hey, Sandra. Damn it. The only reaction videos I like are old people and gaming. Old people gaming and teens retro gaming. The place you just thought where you came in is where you want to go. Yep. Death count zero, though. That's good. Yeah, I didn't die. Just woke back up. When you see Jack films clap back to a jinx. I don't know what that phrase means. But, Randy, if it's a YouTuber, I probably haven't seen it. Reacting to reaction videos? I mean, you joke, but somebody has bound to have tried it. Bound to have. Shit. I don't know where I'm going. Also, like, there are Let's Plays of Let's Plays. Or rather, Retsuprey. I'm pretty convinced I'm going the wrong way. Oh, how quickly things get out of control in this game! I probably could have beat the game by now. I don't know what I'm doing. Is it this way? Sure, whatever. This falls down? Yeah, we're good. Hey, Sutton Plant! Kids watching Sesame Street. Awesome. Wait. God, fuck off, dude! Give me a minute! I thought the dogs were here. Where are the dogs? Go away! Shut up. It is through here, right? Where the fuck? How did I already forget where I'm going? The gate. The dogs are next. God damn it. There. Go back to right. It's bridge. Jesus Christ. It's bridge, hole, gate, dogs. So the gate. The dogs are after the gate? Through the gate? Right? Jesus Christ. Shut up! Are the dogs around here? God damn it. Outside the village to the right. These fucking dogs again. Shut up, shut up. Shut up! There! Jesus Christ. Go away! I've seen Parasite. I've seen the first 3 episodes, I think. I want to watch more of it. It was actually really good. What games am I streaming next? I don't know. I was thinking about playing Street Fighter V. I think I'm far enough in The Witness that I can start streaming it now. Rather, like, the magic moment has kind of come and gone. I'm already poisoned. I don't need to get my old... How did I run past the door again? What is wrong with me? There it is. What the shit? What's wrong? Yeah, Snake Eater theme plays in the background. I'm playing much more Fallout. I kind of don't want to. That game's boring. Oh, okay, it didn't look like a door from that side. I feel like I should finish it, just to finish it. But... Wait... Oh, another item. You know I need that. It's just not interesting. I'd probably play Witcher 3. That's probably the next big one. Big, thick RPG I'll pick up. Maybe Dragon Age Inquisition? I've been meaning to play that for a long time. Alright, Kingdom Hearts. Ooh, call it. That's a good idea. That is a good idea. Fallout is boring. Yeah, I liked Fallout 1 and 2. You know what? I could play New Vegas. I never played that one, and I loved Fallout 2. And I think Obsidian makes fantastic RPGs. Like, actual, real, bomb-ass RPGs. Fallout is worth it only for the mods. Yeah. Yeah, Dragon Age Inquisition is a good one. And I was playing it on super hard because Dragon Age is a fun... Or rather, I wanted the Dragon Age Origins experience. I was playing on Xbox, and some of the controls were a little funky. It's a witness worth buying. Only one monorail. If you like puzzle games, absolutely. If you like puzzle games and maybe more relaxed, pretty games, I think it is absolutely worth the money. But you have to like that kind of game. I don't think it's a game that just anybody would enjoy. Is Tomb Raider worth $8? Yeah. Which one? I'm assuming it's the reboot one. That's a really good game. I think it's definitely worth $8. What Kingdom Hearts games have I played? I played all the major console ones, which is 1 and 2. I played one for DS, I think. And I played a couple hours of Dream Drop Distance. Yeah, Black Nerd? The DLC for that's good, huh? Hey, you. Hey, you. Oh, you're the Cthulhu dude. Shit. Yeah, you... Fuck you. Would you play Journey? I already have. I don't really see the need to play that game again. I've never played Flower. I always wanted to do that. Destiny alienated a lot of people with its asshole pay for content that should have been in the game, Strat. Yeah. Well, you can say that, but it seems to have sold really well. It's popular. I think people are actually more tolerant of that than the gaming elite might want to think they are. The previous Dude Soup, your main demographic was 30-year-old males, but as a 16-year-old whose friends watch Funhouse, it surprised me. No, it wasn't 30 capped. It was 18 to 34, which is the demographic, like the key demographic typically for advertising. That is what YouTube tells us. But that's a very wide age range. And it's only divvied up that way because that's typically... Advertisers want to know that breakdown. See? Atoms is a slut for Destiny. I think it's fine to put out a multiplayer game, full game. As long as it has like a really solid and playable set of mechanics and maps in the double digits. I don't see why that should not be allowed. I guess it depends on how good of a shooter it is, but... Again, man, it's just testing. It's testing things. It's not bad to test. And if the market will tolerate a different value than you're willing to pay, then don't buy it. Better not die since you didn't open the gate. I did not open the gate. You're welcome. GoFundMe. Sorry, guys, I really want to play Kingdom Hearts, but I just need a little more support. I need more support from you guys. So if you could like, follow, go to my GoFundMe and my Patreon. Oh boy. Give me your guts! Give me your guts, alien baby! Interesting. You can't... Get inventory restored to max. Interesting. So this is the third one? Nope. Kanehurst summons. Jelly Belly Man! Going back to school tomorrow, any tips? I'm pretty sure you're probably good at school. The thing that always helped me was to actually, like, be mentally aware during class. It's kind of easy to just daydream or assume that you have learned something and then just stop thinking about it. Well, I didn't die. Wait. Fuck, I have this... Wait, is this the beginning of the game? Looks like it. What helped me was to actually, like, be aware during class and think about things and like, play with the information in my head. And even if I felt like I had the concept, like, do practice problems from the book. And what I realized is, and it's kind of a time management thing, is I'm spending all this time in class. Sitting around, wasting my time. And then I spend all this other time doing homework outside of class. So I'm doubling up the time I'm investing and getting the same amount out of it. So I might as well use the time in class to either practice and get better at it so I do my homework faster, or just do my homework from another class or something like that. So I would say make the most of your time in class because you're stuck there anyway. Just be efficient about it. That was a little life hack that occurred to me. And mostly it revolves around just don't be lazy. Like, if your mind's kind of full and you need to chill... Oh, we got a sub-hype. Then, you know, just know yourself, but... Instead of just sitting there and being bored, do something. Especially if it's going to save you time that you could better use on something else. Like playing video games. Alright, we gotta pop out a rad-ass sub-hype song. Thank you for subbing, the Calfo. Haven't seen you in chat yet, but that's cool. I'm a chronic lurker. I've gotten a little more courageous. Now I'll like type things in all caps during FGC tournaments, but that's about where my my chat integration begins and ends. So let's play a rad track, and I hope you enjoy your song. Some trance. So for somebody asking who that was off of an Above and Beyond collection called Group Therapy. Let me see if I can... Yeah, it's just Above and Beyond, I guess. The name of the song would be Black Room Boy. So, I still have to find this umbilical cord. Julian, you're going man bun? Hopping on that train? Hopefully that hasn't gone out of fashion already. It's still a thing, right? Also, Kala said, yeah, it's music that plays in a Hollister. Ugh, Jelly Baby! Chill Hop. Oh, a new room! I can't remember what it was called already. It was a communion, right? Yeah, the plus three. Man buns are cool. Alright, good. Just wanted to check. I saw them, and then they kind of went away already. At least around. I don't know. Still good as long as they're not also top knots. Wait, you can do both? Or is it just one or the other, and it shouldn't be a top knot? If you wanted a man bun, you could do it. Maybe you should check it out. Give it a try. I know a lot of, or rather, I have seen ladies salivate over the man bun beard combo, but it usually has to be on a pretty big guy with like maybe tattoos and flannel. Something that implies like new age savagery. What's up, Dobster? Fuck boy buns. Shit, yes. Hopefully you have thick hair. Uh-oh. How you doing? I'm your doctor. Heard you had a little accident you wanted to undo, huh? How's it going?
God, I'm nauseous.
Evangelion fan? I do like Evangelion, but I've only seen the original series. I haven't even seen End of Eva. I should catch up on Eva. I know the re-release was pretty good.
I'm no beast.
Thanks for the resub, Hugh Chesko.
Oh, God, it feels awful.
Lumbersexual. Kind of.
Proof that I'm
it's a little... It's a bit of a twist on that, I think. So I gotta take her out and rip the uterus intestine out of her belly.
Rapturous.
So I have to kill her, huh? That seems mean. I'm gonna let chat confirm that I gotta stab this lady. Because I don't want her. She's not having a good time. Smack a hoe, 10 points. What's up, Oak P? She killed the OG Yosefka? I'm not sure who that is. Kill her, yes. Alright, sorry. Alright, boys. So you just use the three, and then you talk to the homeboy, and then you resist, and then you fight your... Yeah? Oh, she's an evil bitch anyway. Well, there you go. Kill her. Do it, mercy killing. Okay. Apparently she deserved it, which somehow erases all of my guilt. Le portimor. I don't know French. I don't even know why I try. God, you monster. How could you? Okay, I'm just back here. Oh yeah, Lantern's right out here. Yosuke ran that hospital, she was an imposter. Wait, nope. How did I get back to the entrance? That was pretty cool. Oh, it's the other way. Alright. Where can you see my PC specs? I really should add them to the bio. Enough people ask about them. Apparently that's a thing I should do. I have a 2500K, which I'm hoping to upgrade to a 4690K soon. And a GTX 970. Oh, right. Oh, you. That's pretty much it. That's the important stuff. I have RAM. There is RAM there. I'm hoping to upgrade my monitor to a G-Sync 144Hz. And then, what other tricks? Oh, yeah, I bought a Steam Link, so I'm excited to... I'm basically going to be all PC once that thing gets here. I'm excited for that. I've also read that you can use the 360 wireless receiver with the Steam Link, so that's awesome. I can finally bust out my receiver. Why not Skylake? Mostly, the benchmarks I've seen haven't justified the cost, and DDR4 doesn't even seem to be that much of a practical advantage in terms of gaming. Alright, is that all the uterus strength? Can we fight the boss now? I think I just broke my wall. I used to have 36 gigs of RAM, and then I had 32, because I had 4 8-gig sticks, and half of it never got touched. I kept an eye on it, so I was like, fuck it, 16 is good enough. Alright, I gotta use the bathroom, get ready for this big bad boss, so see you guys in a second. I'll be right back. Thank you.
got it. He's got it set. He's got a long bar of T-bar.
Okay, I'm back. Eat the cords so you don't forget. Quality advice. To eat them? So gross. Oh, he doesn't eat them, he squishes them. Might as well use all my cold blood and level up too. I'm eating them! I'm eating them! Thank you guys for being diligent and reminding me though. No, oh, beer. I'm watching another Final Fantasy IX stream. I've been waiting to replay that game. I haven't been just sitting on it, but I've definitely, like, had the hankering to play it again. Because, man, I have such good memories of it. But it was one of the first Final Fantasies I didn't 100%. Because going up to 8, I collected everything, did everything, fought every optional boss, and I mean, it's not like that's a huge brag. There were, what, 5 of them out at that point? Coming up on your 1-year anniversary joining the Risley family, what are your thoughts on that year? It's been amazing. It's been awesome. It's been kind of frustrating to start over in some respects, but it's been just amazing to work with Rooster Teeth. Those guys are awesome. I think more than any other company I've ever seen, they have been able to do what they want to do and like make it work on their terms for a long time, and have never lost that soul, which is really, really cool and rare. Let's see. Who's the biggest nerd at Funhouse? We're all nerdy in our own way. I think that's not really an easily answerable question. I think traditionally it's probably me, maybe James, maybe Spool. Any ideas why everybody likes to pick on Blaine so much? I don't know. I don't know. I couldn't answer that. I'm not around there. Biggest nerd is Matt. Learning to play Blitzball again. Nice. Who's the least nerdy? Either Bruce or Matt, probably. Favorite out of the first 10 Final Fantasy games for what reasons? Joshua, I probably like... Yeah, probably 6 the best. Just because it kind of hit at a perfect moment for me. So timing, obviously, is a big part of that. But it had incredible music, it had a great cast of characters. It was really kind of colorful. It had, for... as I perceived at the time, pretty good writing. Like, it had pretty complicated and interesting stories and a lot of character depth that you could read into. Maybe not necessarily in the game because it wouldn't fit, but... It's...
Good hunter,
I have very, very nice memories of all that.
You will be free.
I don't want to be freed.
From this
terrible. Here we go. Any other YouTube celebs you'd like to meet that you haven't yet? Not really. No, I'm pretty good. Don't spam X. Yeah, I paid attention. This boss is just as badass. Yeah, the Reaper Nurse was cool. It was like something from Diablo. I was planning on a Seattle live show. Yeah, we already did one there. The live shows are a little complicated. We got some things to work out about that.
Oh, it doesn't matter. Comes down to the hunters. Help her to clean up after these sorts of messes.
Shit. He's got a cool weapon.
Tonight, Gammon joins the hunt.
Coming to New Zealand? Probably not. Not unless there's an event there. Oh, that's a big hit. Okay, you're a fast motherfucker. Alright. Got a lot of health, too. I'm sure he'll freak out or go beast mode or something. He's gonna do something. Ooh! Ow! Can you visceral attack him? Oh, that's a stupid idea. It seems like you can, though. His attacks... God damn it. His attacks seem predictable enough. Foolishly thought I might be able to poise lock him. This music is pretty intense, though. Shit. Damn it! God, he always gets me with that thing. Alright, we're learning. No big deal. God! Jesus. So I just have to get distance when he poses like that. Damn! How do I not get hit with that? Ah, shit. Alright. Oh no! He's gonna shoot me a lot. Sorry guys, I'm gonna take a lot of hits while I'm trying to figure this out. Fuck. Ah! Damn, that's fast. That does no damage though. So I get at least one free hit. Oh, shit! God damn. Ah, you got me. It's crazy, because you can stun him with your gun, you just gotta be good at it. There are times where, like... I don't know, you're mashing circle, but the window between you recovering from hit stun and being able to dodge is just ridiculous. Use the old hunter's bone if you won't use the gun any. Oh, it's something you can equip? I thought it was a weapon. Or sorry, I thought it was a spell. I don't know what you're talking about. It's an item, not a weapon. See? The art of quickening speeds up rolling at quick steps. Yeah, that sounds like a nice thing, but just get good, bro. I'm getting good. Uses bullets. Oh! It's an applicable buff. Wait, so what, how do you use it? Oh, kickflips! Out of here. Oh shit, okay. Red kickflips. Okay, hold on a minute. It's an item. Gotcha. Ah, man, I had no idea that's how you use that. Right? I don't think I can use it! Yeah, I need 15 arcane or whatever. Okay. I gotta pick out a year song for kickflips. You know what? This may not be personally attributable, but just the name Rad Kickflips makes me think of this music. So thank you for a year of subscriptions. I hope that you enjoy this rad kickflippy song. Had to stop it at some point. Or maybe I didn't. Oh man, we got a sour please. Nice. So yeah, that's what I think of. Rad kick flips over cars that are maybe on fire while some punk music plays. Am I already out of vials? I guess so. I thought I had some. See, versing final boss. I guess so. I need to farm up some vials, though. Unless I'm just gonna do more learning runs. I guess I can. Sure, why not? I guess until I run out of vials and that's why I die, there's no reason to farm them. This turned into a smoke door? That'd be pretty cool. It did! Neat. Alright, here we go. Where you at? Where you at, guy? There you are, homie. That shit hurts, don't it? Nope. I know I got a lot of bullets, so I can just, like, try and blind fire. Oh, he's still attacking. Oh, back dodge. Thought he was gonna give up some point. Damn it. Fuck, he's got range. Okay, so I can poise stun him when he gets like that. I can just... There we go. Get up! Get up! Well, I didn't visceral attack on him. Okay. Shit, he's got a dragon punch. Gonna step forward. Ow. Shit, he's fast. You're gonna transform, now's when you do it. There he goes. Now he's gonna fuck my shit up. Oh, he visceral attacks me! Woo! What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? What is this? Cool. Yeah, I know. I'll switch to short cane next run because I did notice that if you dodge roll forward, you're basically in close, so I might as well use the cane. I have no idea what's happening, but I like it. Next level tech. I mean, it's weird, right? Like, I assumed it was maybe going to be a healing spell, because he's just that kind of asshole. So I just stayed close, and I was like, alright, let's see what you got. I am going to use... I'm going to do some runs on that, on that one lane with all those pigs and shit. You get like 30k each time, so I do a couple runs, get a couple stat points in the offing, fill my junk back up. What was that last song? That was Power of the Big Slacks by Junkie XL. Let's use the three chords. Yes, James, I have. Just crouch tech, fade EC. Yeah, and then I can move right up. Yeah, sorry, I tend to think about games like this in terms of fighting game. Wait, this is not where I thought it was. In terms of fighting game, wait, you said for mid? In terms of fighting game terminology. Because essentially that's what you have to boil it down to, right? I mean, if you want to get inside the game. Do that or help people kill the third boss, or the bird boss, where it's like 50 echoes each time, matchmaking is normally fast. I don't need to grind. I'm just saying I need blood vials. And that seemed like a pretty good lane to get them in. Yeah, I gotta use footsies, absolutely. Last words. What is this? God, could you imagine if there was like a competitive game and every time there was just a spill where somebody glowed and then blew up? Except it was something like that every time you played. Just like, what the fuck, man? How do you get to keep doing that shit? I don't get to blow up. Alright, here, let's go back to the base. I remember how to get up there from there. Have some downtime to collect our thoughts while the elevator's going up and down. It is. Go from the bird area, work your way down. You can make a decent amount. Oh, this'll work. That's on Paragon? Beh. I don't need I don't need another MOBA in my life. Need health? You think I have little health? I thought I actually had a fair amount of it. I thought I had leveled up health pretty well. Alright. Pretty sure these guys are pretty easy to take out, because you can visceral. Visceral. I should have equipped the rune for more visceral points. Vissy points, kids call them. Get out of here. 3,000? Eh. I don't get out of bed for less than 5. JT, you remember when I was a noob at the start of this? And that's how these games go. Need more memes? I agree with that. This should be a good time to do the DLC. No! I want to beat the game! I don't want to spend more money in a game I haven't even finished yet. Hyped for Evo. You know what? I am! It's going to be the first Evo for Street Fighter V. And it's going to be chaotic, because the first Evo is always kind of a shit show. In a good way. It's just everybody trying new shit. None of the standards have been set yet. It's a really cool time. Like, a lot of exciting plays, because everything is new. Time for some deep fisting. I mean, I'm mostly just going to make them fight each other. Some of the pigs drop vials. You know what, if my goal is vials, I should probably just go to the central bridge. Because you can get, like, 10 a run. Well, we'll see. We'll see. So I'm using the long axe, though. DLC starts midway. Do it before killing this boss. Eh. I guess it really depends on how this boss fight goes if I want to keep playing. Right. Don't turn around. I don't want you seeing me cry. Yeah, I would have to equip the Nash's OP as fuck. I mean, at the beginning of every fighting game, there is a character that's always OP as fuck. So I don't understand why people freak out about that stuff. It is known. No. How'd they lose track of the other one? You're still chasing me? Oh, shit! Alright. Yeah, fuck that shit. That's too... It's too risky. It's not folding laundry enough. And plus, I would have to go re-equip the runes to get more echoes. I feel like I should do that, though. That seems like a good way... Okay. I'll re-rune myself. Spec myself out. I like Street Fighter V, I just can't get used to the mechanics. When you punch the opponent, the game pauses. Yeah, there's a lot of frame stopping in Street Fighter V. It's interesting. I mean, Devil May Cry had that. Just run past them. I'm trying to fight them. I'm trying to farm them for souls. Just run past them, heads up for farming. I know, I did, but the one didn't chase me all the way, so... That is why I tried going and getting him. Markers from slain enemies. Markers from V attacks. And then... Those are the echo boosters, right? More items? Why not? Okay. I'll get more... Whatever the fucks. Okay. Okay, let's see if... This one might be faster, as somebody was saying. Actually, wait! I can just go to the wet nurse and run down! Right? Yep, death count still at 0. Thanks for keeping track, Julian. Well, I'll do that next time, since I'm warping in and I have to wait for the load anyway. Okay, so something about running past the birds, the Bjords. Uh-huh. The bell lady still... Oh, yep, here it is. Okay. I'm gonna be doing the DLC. Roasted, I'm not sure. I still haven't done the optional bosses in this. Are the optional bosses in the challenge Talus dungeons? So the optional boss dungeons are somewhat partially generated? Might as well run to the pigs. You get a main in Street Fighter V, and why is it Armika? Because of dead ass. I don't know. I actually... So... My utter dedication to animated breasts aside, I'm actually really interested in Laura. I played Sean in Street Fighter III. And I don't know if she's similar, I've only seen a little bit of her. But I've heard that she's kind of the dopey Dan character. And I always have a soft spot for those characters. I played Dan in, I can't remember what. Which Street Fighter, but... Nice! Man, he fucked them up. Awesome. Now I just sit here and reap the benefits. Oh, that was fast. Enter my cone of death! Oh! You entered it! Fuck! I don't want to waste any vials while I'm trying to farm them. There we go. Probably can't run up behind them. Don't turn around! Damn it, that was it. Do that again. Do that again. Don't do that. Do the other one. Do it. Do it. There you go. Shit. Fuck. Fuck! He attacks again?! Ah! Oh well, I can come back and get my echoes. Best way to farm souls is higher level chalice dungeons. So does it generate a... Does it generate a dungeon based on your level? Is he still fighting final boss? Yeah, D. Franklin, I am. I'm trying to farm up blood vials, actually, but I'm doing it in an inefficient manner. Or rather, I'm getting used to this manner of doing it. And yeah, I'm still at zero deaths, in case you were curious. I know you haven't... And you kind of left for a while. Just wanted to reassure you no deaths have happened while you were gone. Oh, you heard that. You heard that. I was hoping I could just get behind him. Most dungeons are fixed. So do you get to choose which one it makes, or does it just assign you one? The more you do, the higher level I get. Ah! That's what I was looking for. Okay. Well, I haven't done any, so I don't think that's a direct way of farming right now. Alright, did it drop on a pig, or... It did. Shit! Fuck you! God damn it. You guys fight it out. Oh. Awesome, they got the... Don't want to use blood echoes here! Wait, if they kill it, I don't get my echoes back? Oh, they haven't killed it yet. Okay. Oh, they haven't killed it at all. Damn it. Didn't even hurt it. Much. Shit! Fuck you! Damn it! Asshole! Fine, I'll just whip you to death. There! Now I have echoes and vials. My master plan worked off. Paid off. Whatever. You will still get your echoes back. Okay. They just didn't kill it. First ones are easy as balls. You'll go through them in no time. I mean, yeah, but it's not the most expedient path to what I want, which is blood vials and an amount of echoes to level up. Slowly level up. Therefore, I both learn about the boss, and my stats go up slowly. Oy, what the? Oh, that's right. It's not back yet. Fuck off! You don't get to kill me. Damn it, I thought I was gonna visceral that guy, but whatever. Yeah, it's shaving minutes off my speedrun. You're absolutely right. If it looks like I'm getting hurt, it's actually to make me go faster, and it's because I'm good. So remember both of those things. It's that I'm getting hit because I want to, and I'm good. Don't use the echoes to level by vials. That's probably a good idea. But I want to level some too. I feel like that's just a safe way to... Yeah, is damage boosting as invulnerability frames? I guess, sure, whatever. Fuck it. That's smarter than, like, 3 stat points, which probably won't amount to much. At least this way I'll get to learn the pattern. And really figure out if I need to level up more. Not because I'm gonna die to the boss, or that my stats are too low or anything like that. It's more like, you know, just to... Listen, I'm a professional streamer, so I want it to be fun for you guys. God, this fucking lock on. I get more hits on his backdash when I use the whip, though. So I think that might actually... God damn it. Fucker! That's it, huh? Oh, no. I kinda don't want to waste. Jesus Christ. Okay. I was experimenting with going in aggressive on him and it didn't work. Thanks for the resub, Artistic. Could use co-op. I wanna try it. The wall jump boost glitch. Help skip half the game fast. No, I will never share that secret with you, because I am a professional streamer and a professional speedrunner. I respect the craft too much. Bait and parry is quite effective. Sorta. My gun's slow. Oh, I see what you mean. Not like parry with a gun. But, yeah, just like, move around. That's what I did the first time, and it worked out pretty well. Damn it, it's fucking Dragon Punch. I just basically have to hope he doesn't do that. Fuck! The timing on that is so weird! Wait, it can work, but you have to dodge better. JT, that's what you do by dying to a boss over and over. Learning dodge timing is not like... That's just rote. You just have to mash your head against it until you memorize it. That's what I'm doing. I'm head mashing. It's not like I'm getting bested in a game of chess here. No, Baxter, pretty much nothing's going on. Or rather, I don't know what's going on either, to make it clear. I'm fighting this guy. Fuck. That's weird, I could dodge out of that before. Wow. Ran so fast, escaped my lock-on. Alright. I'll be a little more careful. Okay, so it is probability based, whether or not I can interrupt. Because it looked like I knocked him out of his Dragon Punch the first time, but then I didn't. Okay, so it's best to get him on the back dash. If I can interrupt him, then I will. God damn it. Ugh! God! I do enjoy how Bloodborne fights look super anime, with dudes like dashing around all fast. Oh, I'm surprised that interrupted him. Okay, now this is the one I can dodge forward, I feel like. Ha! Ah. Oh! Yeah, I feel like I would get more hits on his runaway with the whip. Even if it does less damage, a few more hits would be worth it. Well, I still don't get him on... Damn it, I thought he was gonna run forward. and get him in that forward dash. If he decides to do it like that, and get him on the roll. Ugh! Too early. Okay. Oh, that's right, he goes Hulk first. I missed out a shitload of free damage, though. Oh, he's casting a spell. Okay, I see the radius of that now. Alright. Okay, I can't interrupt him anymore. Well. Alright, good to know. Also, apparently you can't fucking take one combo. Whee! Yeah, it is pretty Metal Gear Solid 3-esque. Lady Maria's more anime dash. We still fighting the same motherfucker? Man, we are. Rather, there was an interlude there where I farmed up a shitload of vials so I could just kind of grind out attempts on this guy. I don't know if the fire paper's gonna be worth it. Yeah, wombos. If you can catch a wombo, it's weird. It's tough to convince yourself to use consumables like that. Because you know that, you know, you just hit, your thumb slips off the stick for a second and you die, and that's it. So, not a lot of recovery. You can't go all in on a play. Yeah, you. Get a little closer. Timing was shit. See, I interrupt. Ugh. Fuck, I'm. Ugh. That's weird. You can catch his rhythm. But Jesus, it's easy to fall out of it. It's weird because his first and second forms will look really similar, but they're really, really not. I gotta remember. Because you get into a good rhythm, and then he switches. Hey, Steph. Trying to kill the last boss. Ultimate last boss.
Weren't you like almost done with this?
Yeah, I'm on the last boss. I was being almost done.
But I thought that you were like almost done with this like Thursday.
I had a couple.
See?
I was in the last part of the game. I still think that's almost done.
I guess.
Ugh. What times have I died? I don't know. I'm not. I mean, the answer is zero, but I don't know. Get versatile attacks, can do massive damage, just can't do it when he's blue. His first form isn't too dangerous if I'm safe, which I wasn't. I just gotta remember what to go in on and what I can't. Fuck, shit. Christ. What the shit? Ugh! Alright. It's weird. The second you think you have him figured out, he seems to... Shit! Seems to change. Okay. So just wait for his entire combo. But he ends on different hits. See, it's frustrating when it's like... There's no predictable safe spot. Just have to dodge through the whole thing every time, huh? Come on. Damn it. I'm starting to get it. Damn it! Fuck! I was busy healing. She's gonna get me. Ugh! Oh, okay. We're doing this now. What the shit? I hit circle. Damn it. Oy. Okay. Yeah.
Ugh. Fuck. Okay. Okay. Fuck it. Oh, he's back in this mode. Shit. Can't tell if he has more reach now or not. Damn it. Oh boy, he can teleport. What is this? Oh my god! Oh, he got spells. It. Oh, no! That's probably it, huh? No, wow, surprisingly. Shit. Can't see! Alright. Damn it! Damn, he backdashes. Sweet. Shit! Alright, we're almost out. Oh! And there we go. Whew. Fuck! Is it just me or does his gun timing change? It really feels like it. No. Okay. Ugh! Sorry?
It's like, did you win, Lauren?
No.
I was hoping that that was a...
Oh, man. Hold on, I got... Oh, okay, never mind. Thought you were watching the movie.
No. God, not after you being like, hey, your movie caused this shit to happen.
Well, I was going to have to close the things.
You can't do that shit.
You can. I just said I have to close the things. No, the boss was super close to dying. Like, basically one more hit, and it would have died. Ooh, man. That one stung. That one hurt deep. Whatever. Man. So do you go right into the next boss fight without being able to buy more items or resupply or anything? Get good, scrub. Fusion technique. I should fusion. You're right. Runes. Yes. I should put on better runes. Yeah, if only I could call Mikolash. I miss him.
guess that's a... I mean, if you get lucky, you can kind of use that to... Oh, shit, that's not going to work. I guess this is a good way to get... Ooh! Out of the first thing without using too many vials. Pretty good for that. Shit. God damn it. God, fuck you, dude. Hey. What? There we go. That should give me health back, right? Nope, I switched it. I thought he was in holler mode. What the shit? Dude's got anime dashes. There he goes. Oh wait, I thought he started casting as soon as he got into this mode. No? I guess if you're on him, he just doesn't do it. There he goes. Fuck you. I was trying to cheese him out. So there's only so much health you can really get off of him. Hmm. It could be his yells are pretty great. Very nyai. Kept asking about the runes, but I didn't see. That happens. Second boss follow me, DB, once you kill Garamond, he's dead. Ah, gotcha. Okay. Could use wear my cage helmet, that's true. Repair. Oh, right. Probably should have saved some of my cold blood. Or any of it. Let's see. Visceral attack, vials up. Could be okay. More stamina's good. So, I guess it's physical damage. HP. Alright. I have to do the DLC before New Game Plus. I don't know that I'm gonna do the DLC. Yeah, the building seems to be on fire. Heh, no big deal. No big deal. NBD. I needed, what, like 200? Yeah, fuck it. I'll just go out and kill like 3 things. I just don't know. Probably not gonna do with this. So if you beat the game, you can't start the DLC from that. You'd have to start a new game. That doesn't make sense. Those dancing avocados?
Yeah, they're really cute.
They are really cute.
I only just looked at them. They're really cute.
They're having a good time.
That's why I was like, Lawrence, this is really important. You should go look at this.
Little avocado party. Oh, thank you. Ring the bell, dude. No, Johnny. I mean, I got really close. I'm good. I can beat this. Oh, fuck. Just give me an enemy. Give me something to kill. I should have gone to a place where I knew there were dudes. Ugh. I'm not a very smart person. Alright, I'm just gonna go directly to where I know there are echoes right next to the damn thing. But I never opened this? Fine. Whatever. Fuck it. I'll just go the other way. Use the fusion bell. It's not bad advice, but I'm pretty confident I can get this guy by myself. Actually, you know what? I guess I could just say, like, yeah, I've got his number, I might as well. So I don't just stick on this forever. There's no need to be prideful. There. Go show the concept art. We finally published the application pages. Yeah, sure, Froman. Please show me your comic. And becomes a joint speed run time. Oh, you're right, Doctor.
Oh, Jesus.
What? Oh.
I'm reading this. I'm reading the West or the LA College this expansion thing.
Okay.
Because I'm kind of curious to see what little classes that they offer. And there is an 85-hour program that will prepare you to be a retail sales associate or customer service representative.
Cool. You have to take a class to learn how to work retail?
Yeah, but, well, that's the thing. Exactly. It says...
That's the worst idea.
You will cover retail smarts, which I'm guessing that's an acronym for something. Guest service skills, handling cash, check and credit card transaction, product knowledge, and dealing with customer requests and complaints. Also covers general retail and wholesale job skills, personal branding and online direct sales, and social media strategies used by major retailers. I want you to take a wild fucking stab in the dark what you think this costs. 85 hours. How much do you think this class costs, Lawrence?
It's at a community college?
Yes.
$4,000?
$1,395.
Okay. I have no idea how,
That's fucking stupid. Just
that is stupid.
And at least you can pay minimum wage.
Yeah, while to do that. It. Hey, colleges sell education, and if people are willing to pay for it, I guess that's all that matters.
There's also a restaurant server one. Which I kind of feel like... I guess you can say handler, you can, but... $14.95. When you could probably work in a restaurant.
Finally. My vlog dreams are real. Now everyone will like me. Damage I'm not getting on him. Okay. Oh, right, you can't stun him.
I think if I sign you up for blogging for fun and profit, I could get you a percentage off Aquas in
the... That's good news. Okay. Hey. We do need to make a lash. That exhausted sigh.
This woman teaches like 19 classes at this extension thing, Lawrence. also apparently took the stand-up comedy class and then went to Europe. And apparently started that. She's like, seriously, she's named as like that she started community college when she was 48, and then she graduated from UCLA at turning 50.
No one's something to do. Actually, that sounds pretty good. Should have been closer. Like, it's gonna be rough without. Oh, fuck off. He missed! That gun follow-up. Oh! Don't. That was a pretty big choke on his part. Okay, now this. Oh my god, this terrible thing. On to the final boss. Holy shit. That is a cool looking thing. Oh no! It hugged me. I was not expecting something like that to be in this game. Moon presence. Shit is this? So it just dogs you down, huh? It's gonna be one of these fights. Maybe just a fucking slog? Oh shit. Alright, cool. So that's that. There's that thing. I guess you just try to manically dodge around it and hope that. God. That timing is something else. That thing fucked me up. God, it fucked me up.
Damn it.
It's like the god of the creatures, the reason why the moon is red. Alright. Yeah. Okay, there you are. Alright. That's kind of a long attack. Got a claw, 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 claw. A lot of claws. One. Still attacking. I don't know when it stops. There's that one. I know that one. His range on that one. No! Shit, come on. Okay, so that's a lot of... God damn it! A lot of clawing when it holds its head. That means back the fuck away. God, it's fast!
Yeah, beat it, Vader!
Stephanie's playing Battlefront. I feel like I can get in, get one hit, and get out. At best. Oh, I can't even do that. Okay. So you have to dodge through the attacks. Fucking shit. God damn it! I'm dead. I think it's one of the bosses where you don't get to do anything unless it's in recovery from a combo. Like, you have to dodge and dodge and dodge and dodge and dodge and continue dodging. Roll forward? No, Tame. Like, the timing of some of those combos is so rough. I can roll into the wide area ones that have, like, a bit of recovery on them, but I don't think I can roll through a full one of those combos unless it doesn't spin to, like, see you instantly. And no tips, suggestions maybe. I'll figure it out. See, look at that. And the timing of it is so hard to see because it's like clipping into the ground a little bit. Alright. Try getting closer. Just getting in the mix. When he jumps, the camera pins it, goes into the grass. I can't see it. But I think, at the rate I'm doing damage, staying close is probably the better option. Basically, that means I have to get its rhythm for maybe 30 seconds. Maybe a minute. That's not too bad. Dun, 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 dun. Looking for awesome music? I always am. Oh, shit. Hold on. Let me... Fuck, it's gonna kill me. It's gonna kill me. I like that. I like what you just did there. That was good. Shit. What? It hits the other side? Ugh. Shit. I thought that was purely on one side. If I can get in on it, I can do an amount of damage. I
What the shit? Oh, good. Great, good. Good, good. Oh. Does attacking it hurt me now? What shit was that? Oh no, it was just hurting me. Okay, weird. What the shit? It just does that? Okay. What are you doing? Oh, those are all bombs, huh? Oh! Okay. Oh, that just takes you down to one health. Oh, and you have to get it all back. Oh, I'm a stupid idiot. That's really smart. Is that it? Is that it? Cool.
Are you cool?
Yep. Zero death run, Bloodborne, true ending. That's it, huh? It really is a Cthulhu monster.
Oh, good hunter.
Sorry, Joshua. I didn't mean to... Didn't mean to sound underwhelmed.
Fuck you!
I just, I thought maybe it was a trick last boss with, like, another story, or another bar of health or something like that. Any advice for breaking up with somebody? Well, Raxer, I guess embrace that it was for the best. Use this opportunity to focus on yourself. Distract yourself. Hey, Turbid. Ah, cool. Congrats, watch the credits. So what does the speed time end at? Oh, I mean, yeah, sorry, I forgot to stop my timer. It's okay. I set the world record by at least 30 minutes, so... Hold on a second, kickflips. Now a pacifist run? Yep, you got it. Secret ending. No, Froman, you did the right thing. Play Mario 64 while completing a game in as few button presses as possible. Gorilla Biscuits, no H3 reference. I haven't watched their stuff. Okapi. I don't know that I'm gonna end, but I'm gonna play something else. Probably something on PC. Kingdom Hearts, right? I don't have it out. Shit. Kinda wanna play Kingdom Hearts, though. Yeah, actually, you know what? I'm gonna say yes. Although it's gonna have to install, right?
Yeah.
What's up, Stella? Oh, I'm getting murdered?
Ah.
Baxter, why was that lady holding a squid at the end? I don't know. Well, fucking means never touch this gray world again. Gotta leave, Rain? Alright, see you, man. Oh, okay, Gorilla Biscuits, never mind. But yeah, I think I'm gonna dust off the old PS3, get Kingdom Hearts working. I guess I can play Ratchet and Clank in the meantime, that's on PS3. Could pick that one back up. Have you played the Kingdom Hearts games before? I have, yep. It's okay, Kala.
What the shit?
Gotta wait for this alternate ending, and then it's probably gonna be down for a bit. I gotta move some chords around and plug some things in, but... For a man, I really like Bloodborne. And yeah, I would like to play Darkest Dungeons, too.
But what I like about Bloodborne is it seems like there's fewer weapon sets, fewer weapons, like fewer ways to engage enemies. And since that set is smaller, it seemed a lot more like razor tuned. I don't know, in a weird way it felt a little more considerate, a little more, I guess, less scattershot, you know, because Dark Souls kind of feels like there's a bunch of swords in it, and nobody really played through the game with all of them. They just kind of set the variables where they thought it would be a decent weapon, but not overpowered. But then you get all these kind of weird glitches and cracks in the system where you can find a different way to play, and then there's all the platforming stuff you can exploit. Bloodborne didn't really feel that way.
Stupid.
It felt more like a beat-em-up, like a character action game. Have anime night again? Ah, it's been a while, hasn't it? Once Senran Kagura comes out, Dead or Alive Extreme. I don't know, I wanted to pick up Trails in the Sky. Cold Trails? Cold Steel? Steel in the Sky? Something like that. It looked really cool. Like a PlayStation 1 era tactical RPG. Playing Mafia 2? Not really, no. I passed that game by. I never had a strong urge to play it. It seemed neat. I've actually thought about picking up the Yakuza series, because those look awesome. More arcadey. That's a good way of putting it. Yeah, Dark Souls 3 hype. I'm excited for Dark Souls 3. Trails in the Sky, that's it. Very finishable. Doesn't require 300 hours. Interesting. I thought I heard from people saying that they put like 40 hours into it, which is still pretty manageable. It's not as bad as a Tales game. Which, Kingdom Hearts? Probably. I'll just start at 1, see if it grabs my interest. Yeah, in order. Which other one? Do they have any of the side Kingdom Hearts on... Actually, I should ask. Hey, Steph.
What?
Can I borrow your copy of Kingdom Hearts? I thought so. Did you ever unpack it, or is it still in the giant box?
I have it in the box just because it's a set like that.
Okay.
Oh my god, I fucking hate these opening matches with the fucking monkey jumping and the people just doing random fucking emotes all over each other.
That's my favorite part. They do the electrocuted one and they shout.
No, it's fucking weird. It's
awesome.
Super weird and gross.
One is slow, yeah, but it also opens with Fantasia, so.
Fuck your couch!
I started Valkyria Chronicles, but I didn't get very far. It didn't click with me. I think I got stuck in a level.
Delightful.
Yeah, the Roxas Hours, and one slower than that. Watch the two-part video that explains the Kingdom Hearts storyline. It's 2 hours long. Yeah, Adoption, that doesn't surprise me. Playing PC? No, she's playing Battlefront on Xbox. Banner Saga? You want to play that?
God damn it.
Dishonored I have already played. Yeah, I'll keep streaming for a while. I don't know how much longer.
Eat it!
Yeah, Lou Garvey. About to...
God damn it!
Either... start installing Kingdom Hearts, and I might pick up Ratchet and Clank while that's going, because I know games can take a while
to
install.
Boys, don't lose the fucking control point.
Sealed. Now, let's begin the transfusion.
Right.
Oh, don't you worry. Whatever happens, you may think it all a mere bad dream.
Shit. Shut up, I'm going. Tell me what I need to do.
Thinking Plus just starts you like this, it doesn't continue. Yeah, right?
Oh!
This is the good ending? Doesn't seem that interesting. That profound. That's just the beginning of the game, huh?
Whatever.
Oh,
oh yeah.
Shit.
Woke up in Yovska's clinic.
Really?
It's a good ending because you defeated the hunt by killing the moon presence, or the Great One. So, if you defeat the hunt, do you just wake up in another hunt? There's no good ending with Lovecraft or Souls games. That's true, yeah. Okay, guys. What? Why did you do that? Whatever. I'm going to move some stuff around. So, quick break, plus I have to use the bathroom and maybe get a snack. Exciting times. I'll be back in maybe 5 minutes or so.
He's got it set. He's got a long bar, a T-bar. Here it comes. Tetris! 27,000 now, 44,000. Thor Ackerlund under a little bit of pressure, nervously fingering on that controller tonight. He is going to celebrate, or one of these two. Definitely very close to it at the moment. 27,000 right now, 54,000. Thor Ackerlund takes a long bar, sets it down to the right. Now building up the outside wall. A little bit of trouble, but no, he gets out of it with a Tetris!